We're making a start here with the latest as far as the Reserve Bank of India's credit policy is concerned. Now, as expected, the central bank kept the repo rate and reverse repo rate unchanged. So the key interest rates remain unchanged for the seventh straight credit policy in a row. In fact, RBI governor said that policy support from every front is required for recovery, which he termed as nascent and hesitant at this point in time, although he did say that recovery is slowly coming back on track and that the economy is in a better shape as compared to at the beginning of the pandemic. The committee has also retained the GDP projection of 9.5% for the fiscal year 2021-22. But RBI has raised its inflation forecast for each quarter of the current financial year and also inflation estimates for the full year have been raised to 5.7% from earlier estimate of 5.1%.
In June, headline inflation remained above the tolerance level, but price momentum moderated. Also, core inflation softened from its peak in May. Taking all these factors into consideration, which I have now just spelled out, the projection for real GDP growth is retained at 9.5% for 2021-22. Real GDP growth for Q1 22-23, that is next financial year, is projected at 17.2%. We are in the midst of an extraordinary situation arising from the pandemic. At this stage, therefore, continued policy support from all sides, fiscal, monetary, and sectoral, is required to nurture the nascent and hesitant recovery. Accordingly, the MPC decided to retain the prevailing repo rate at 4% and continue with the accommodative stance with all its nuances.
All right, well, inflationary pressures is something that we've been seeing given the fuel prices and other also inflation in other areas as well over the last several months. But what does this mean now as far as your interest rates are concerned, as far as your loans are concerned? Let's bring in Harsh Rungta, certified financial planner, who's joining me at this point in time. Harsh, thank you so much for joining us on Mirror Now. What would be the advice at this point in time for those who want to take loans or those who already have loans, given the fact that, at this point, it's been seven consecutive credit policies where we haven't seen any movement on interest rates at this point in time because of inflation, obviously. So what does that mean for one's home loans?
Well, I think for quite some time now, the home loans have been on floating rate, which means that no matter when you take them or if you have already taken them, you had to be resigned to the fact that interest rates will go up and down. In the Indian context, of course, those who have already taken loans, the EMI normally does not change. The tenure goes up or down depending on interest going up or down. So, I mean, it does not have too much of an immediate cash flow impact for existing borrowers. For new borrowers, if interest rates go up, then obviously it will have an impact in terms of how much loan they can get, etc. Currently, most of the major lenders have linked their lending rate to RBI's repo rate, which, as you have yourself said, has not changed. So even though there is an upward pressure, it may not immediately translate into a higher loan rate. Although for some of the private banks which have linked it to money market rates like treasury bill lending rates, etc., they may increase it and therefore, we may see some pressure on loan rates. But as I said, this is something that's going to happen. Home loans are like 20-year loans. And you are going to see up and down on interest rates during the period.
Yes, absolutely, Harsh. And but just on that point where you talked about new borrowers, because so far, given the pandemic, and we've seen a lot of a huge amount of rate cuts, in fact, before the policy went on a pause. And now, of course, given the kind of inflation that we are seeing, do you think that one should perhaps go ahead if you're looking to take a loan to take it at this point in time, or we might see rates going up, maybe not immediately in the near future, but going forward, that is bound to happen now. We're at the end of how much the rates can go down, in fact.
Oh, absolutely. And I think a loan needs to be taken, especially if you're talking home loan. You need to take a home loan when you need to buy a house. So I think you can't really time it. And therefore, if you need to buy a house, then you need to take a home loan. When rates go up, they will go up for you. Now, fortunately, if you have borrowed from a bank, your rate is linked to an external rate so that you are also assured that when it falls, it will also fall for you.
Yes.
Earlier, that was no longer true. Now, at least as long as the lender is a bank, you will get the benefit of a reduction as well as the burden of an increase.
All right, Harsh, we'll leave it there. Thank you so much for joining us with your perspective on this. So that's as far as one's loans are concerned and home loans are concerned. But of course, the other big aspect that we are looking at here is with respect to inflation. Remember, we have seen a lot of inflation pressure in the last few months, and the RBI has now increased its own inflation projection as well going forward, and at this point in time also pointed out that we might see some easing of inflationary pressures as we enter the third quarter. But for now, as far as the projections are concerned, they have been increased quite significantly. In fact, from an earlier estimate of 5.1%, it has gone up to 5.7%. And in fact, quarter-wise also, if you look at for the second quarter, it was earlier 5.4%. Now it is 5.9%. The next quarter was 4.7%, and now it is 5.3%. So that is really what as far as inflation is concerned. But the RBI governor also talked about how policy support is needed for recovery. And the recovery at this point in time is quite nascent and hesitant. But we are at a better stage right now versus how we were at the beginning of the pandemic. And from the second wave setback that the economy, the hit that the economy took as a result of the second wave, the economy is now recovering from that as well. So some important points there being pointed out by the RBI governor during the briefing post the credit policy this morning. So, and he's also said that economic activity has broadly evolved along the lines of the Monetary Policy Committee's expectations, and it is recovering from the setback of the second phase.